is a genius. Paul is a great man. Not because we have been mesmerized by his gift that we have been. Not because his poetic inventiveness and rhetorical genius is so remarkable that it demands repeated listening. It does. He is a great man because he's been willing to roam and look long and to tell the truth along the way. You know, allow me to reintroduce myself. And look, they said, you ain't no sense in lying and saying I can blame my environment. The vibe is still in my vein. Right? I ain't gonna say, oh, it was the society that forced me. I want to do this. There's something about it that is seductive to me. But he says, you can change, but that's just the top layer. You was who you was before you got here, player. Right? And so he's giving us philosophical discussions about the conundrum of identity. He's engaging us philosophically on a number of things. As I point out in the book, he's talking about slavery. He's talking about social injustice. He's dealing with criminal justice reform. I mean, all of the music. And we miss it because he's so clever and he's so sharp that we have to go back and think about the underpinnings of what this man has done. So the reason I wrote that book on his 50th birthday is to try to remind us of the peculiar appeal and the unique genius of a lasting American.
My man, Michael Larry Dyson.
Wait.
If you have any girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but if you
see one... Happy 50th, home.
If you have any girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but if you see one... I got